I've actually had fairly decent luck with inkers in my career. The first couple of years, we tested a lot of people, and then a man named John Stokes ended up inking me for several years. I think I actually might have burned him out. That's always been a problem I find, which was strange because they put inkers on me that had inked Perez, and I wonder if my work must be a different kind of labor. I've seen my pencils are actually vastly different than Perez, even though the sort of surface elements are the same. But people just get tired of it. I think if you know you could either ink me or Paul Smith or someone really simple, you're going to ink Paul Smith because it's the same page rate, and it's so much easier. And I say that not in any way to denigrate a simpler kind of line. It's just often it's physically less work. You're not noodling in the same way that you would have to with my stuff. And I think it was 1998, maybe 99. Andy Lanning, an inker and writer from England, did samples. I don't even remember requesting them. I'm not even sure how he found out who I was. But he did a set of samples that were amazing. And so we put him on as the inker on JLA Titans. And it was unbelievable. I just never felt like I had an inker who understood not only my way of working, but knew how to make it better and knew how to strengthen lines that were weak or push stuff into the foreground that maybe I didn't do in the pencils or most importantly, could ink things like hair. He could do textures in a way that other inkers with me could not or had not to that point. Or had not at least in that way. So it's sort of like this magical combination. And so Andy has been my inker for something like 11 or 12 years, generally. There have been times when he hasn't inked me. Primarily, I think it's my fault because I've been so late that he hasn't had the chance to do it. Or for whatever reason, he was doing something and I had a small project, so he'd come in later. But I can't speak highly enough about Andy, mostly because I've never met anyone who is so professional and so loyal and so gifted. He's so talented. And every time I fail in getting him material, I don't even know how to describe it. Every time I fail getting him material, I really do feel like I'm a bad person. And not just a bad professional, but someone who's not honoring my part of that commitment, because no matter where I go, Andy has been committed to me. And, you know, if I go to Marvel or DC, he will, you know, faithfully follow and faithfully ink my work, and he will hit the deadline when my writer can't or I can't, and it's really remarkable. And I don't think you get that kind of collaboration. I don't think you get that kind of teamwork in this business or in most others. I think Andy and I have only had one or two conversations about process and style, because 99% of what Andy does, I love. And because I'm not always necessarily looking for someone to trace, kind of like with coloring, I love the sense of collaboration. What we do is so ridiculous on some level that I want everyone, particularly the art people, to have fun. I want them to feel like they can bring their voice to it, build off of it. Like, I sort of want to give them a framework and then they can go nuts. Like, if they're gonna labor over my stuff for 12 hours a day, at least they should have fun and be like, yeah, you know, I'm gonna add a thick line here, a thin line here, oh, I'll crosshatch that. So I've never told Andy, don't do anything, I hate this, etc. There are certain things I like, star fields, for example. I like star fields to look a certain way. So it's like, oh, could you ink with smaller stars? No problem. Occasionally, I will ask him to correct something or make something more clear because I don't think it reads clearly. And he'll be like, sure, okay. Like, you know, he's never said no. But I don't think I've ever really spoken. We've spoken about technique and we've spoken generally about style and the materials he likes to work with and the way he works. But I don't think I've ever said, you must ink this way or you must do this way. And if there are slight changes to be made, I'll do them or he'll do them. Usually no questions asked. But I've never really, I feel like I've never had to. I've never had to say, like, Andy, you really need to stop this because it makes me nuts. Because he's just, he's so faithful to the work without being a drone. And because he brings out the stuff that I often don't see. And I like that. I appreciate that.